This is Chris, and this is the Matrixx 9-meter power kite by HQ Kites. So this is the speed system, often called the bridle, on the Matrixx. The 9-meter has a 3-pulley system. You get a little more dynamic range off it. Not only does it change the angle of attack, but it does sort of change the shape of the foil. The 9, the added pulley provides a little more freestyle aspect. The 12-meter and the 15 have a 2-pulley system. From here, it goes up and gets really thin, super thin Dyneema bridles. That reduces drag and helps increase the speed of the wing. Now, it's a closed cell leading edge. It's got a water-resistant sail, and you're wondering, like, well, how does this thing work on the water? Well, the air inflates the wing, pressurizes the wing. There's these one-way valves. The air kind of stays inside. If you hit the ground or the water, the pressure forces this tube closed so water can't rush into the wing. You can't really see it, but there's like a tube sock that runs in the center down into the wing. The kite inflates rather quickly, self-inflating, don't need a pump, just ram air inflation. If anything does happen, there are some dirt outs or water outs on the wing tips that you can let out debris, whether you get some sand or whatever. And there is a channel that's cut along the trailing edge, so if something were to get inside, it is easy to dump and have it removed out the corner tip. When you're done, there's a zipper in the back that opens up, and this lets the air out. Often when I'm folding the kite up to put it away, zip this, bring two ends together, and then you can just push all the air out of the wing. Now, if we take a good look inside of the chamber, you can see there's cross venting. That's required on foils like this, and you can see it's nicely reinforced at the cutouts with some nice Dacron reinforcing, double zigzag stitching, super durable. Kite's gonna hold up to a fair amount of abuse. It's got some nice cross bracing in the wing as well. All right, let's see how she rolls on the water. Jan Hendrik Junker from powerkites.de is going to present the kite and show us how to get started with it. As you can see, it packs ever so small into a compact carrying knapsack. No pump required. The Matrixx is easy to self-launch. Right now he is just unpacking the bag. Normally with this kite, we leave the lines attached to the bridle. He's gonna walk his lines out, and he's gonna use a ground stake to sort of set his lines. As you can see, the kite is actually downwind. This kite's a little bit different in that you can launch it downwind, and you'll see how this works in a bit. When the kite isn't inflated, it doesn't have a lot of pull or lift, so if you've got an area that's a little bit tight, as long as you're able to kind of launch from an upwind position. Now, he's using the ground stake and putting the brake around that. This is a 9-meter Matrixx. It's a closed cell foil. So what you'll see are these portholes in the leading edge. And what happens is they kind of work like one-way valves, allowing air to fill the sail and form the shape of a wing. Until the kite is inflated, it isn't really in a proper airfoil form, so it doesn't quite pull or lift like a real kite until that point. So the Matrixx uses a fifth line system for safety, and you clip in at the chicken loop, and if things go wrong, you can jettison the bar through the chicken loop safety, and the fifth line will pull from the center of the kite, and the kite's wings will flap back sort of taco-ish and come down to the ground with very little power. Now Jan Hendrik just released the brake, and you launch by pulling on the top lines. And the kite doesn't pull too much until the wing is fully inflated, and usually that doesn't really occur until you're at apex. And once you're at apex, the kite's fully inflated and ready to fly. Now to sheet the kite in and out, there is a cam cleat located just above the bar. Currently he's sheeted all the way out, so that's full power. Sheeting in will depower the wing. Pulling the bar back, you'll see a little micro adjustment of power sheeting in and out, and you got more of the macro adjustment there just above the bar at the cam cleat. You can grab the handbrake and bring the kite down, but you must exercise caution. If the wind is really, really blowing hard, you're basically bringing the kite right down through the power zone, so you need to watch out. But if the winds are on the lighter side, you can literally grab the handbrake, pull back, and the kite will come down. Now he's going to secure the kite by unhooking and putting the handbrake under the ground stake, and that keeps the bottom lines tensioned and the kite will remain on the ground. You can also reverse launch by pulling on that handbrake, and the kite will literally come off the ground in reverse. When the winds are light, sometimes you need to choke up a little bit on those lines even more. And if you pull on one side a little bit more than the other, the kite will flip over. So here Jan's on the ground. He's got a hand on the handbrake, and he's gonna reverse launch this by pulling back on it a little bit more on one side than the other, and you can see how the kite just flips right over. Now he's gonna activate the fifth line. The bar shoots up to a point, and the kite tacos. As you can see, the wings are swept back and there's very little pull on the line. He can then fish the kite back by walking up the fifth line. In this case, he's going to reset the chicken loop and try to relaunch. Now he's reverse launching. Got a little piece of wood. That's all right. Another method for launching the kite is burying one wingtip with some sand and then doing a side launch. This is probably a little bit safer because you don't really run the risk of getting overpowered downwind. But this is another technique that you can use to solo launch your Matrixx. So here Jan Hendrik is launching on the side, just burying one wingtip with sand. Avoids the hot launch. This is Jan Hendrik Junker from powerkites.de, test flying the Matrixx 9-meter. Waves Resort, Rodanthe. So Jan Hendrik is going to demonstrate a water relaunch. Oops, he just crashed, leading edge down. He reaches out, grabs the back strap, pulls a little more on one side than the other, and the kite flips right over. Jan Hendrik is demonstrating a water relaunch using the back lines. By pulling on the back strap, he's able to make the kite fly in reverse. If you pull just a little bit more with one side or the other, the kite will spin over quickly and you're able to get it up in the air. All right, Jan Hendrik is demonstrating a water relaunch. He crashes leading edge down and he's going to reach out and grab his back strap. Pull on that. Till the kite opens up. It'll start to flip around because he's pulling one side a little bit more than the other. And then he's back up in the air. When the wing hits the water, the pressure forces the valves closed, so water is not able to rush inside the wing through the portholes. For more information on the Matrixx, check out our website at powerkites.de.